Thanks for joining our video series today. I'm Tyler Camp, Technical Solutions Executive with Autodesk. Part of my role is to speak with clients on a day-to-day basis. And one of the things that I hear frequently is, how can we collaborate better? Whether it's from a general contractor or a subcontractor. And one of the things that they collaborate most on is RFIs, or requests for information. For those that may not know what an RFI is, an RFI is something that you send in contractually to find out clarification, whether it's design intent or if there's something that needs to be adjusted. And it's something that can be very common. And an example that I can give is that maybe I'm a subcontractor, a steel subcontractor, and I need to get clarification on added steel beams. And so I put it in, but I've already had a few questions. So I have a log that I keep track of each question, so it's a number, and I'm on RFI 15. And then I send that to the general contractor. The general contractor may have 50 or more different subcontractors that are all asking questions. And so they might be on RFI 45 when they put it into their system from my RFI. And I call the follow-up a week later saying, hey, where's this at, my RFI 15? And they either say, I have no idea what your RFI 15 is, or they've done an extra amount of due diligence where they're putting it in Excel and doing double entry. And they look in to see my RFI 15, their RFI 45, and that they're trying to keep track of it so I know. And then they send it back to me. And then I put it in Excel or some other system to log that my 15 is their 45. We've now done this more than once, but it's also disconnected. Autodesk really thought about this. How can we help with this? And how we've gone about this is through RFI custom attributes. Now, it's not just RFIs, but what we've done is it allows you to create an RFI, have an attribute that you can trace to a general contractor number or a subcontractor number, and have it reportable and searchable. The custom attributes feature also allows us the ability to do other things that maybe we have a client that wants something in addition. An example is, I was on a particular project where the client asked us to keep track of the design team and any RFI that was related to even their engineers, and to evaluate if it was missed in design and if there was a cost associated. We didn't have a great way to track that, so I had to have a separate log to track all that information. As I did this, it was very labor intensive. Custom attributes allow you to have that additional information to make it more granular and reportable for you as a company, to not only mitigate risk, but even ease that labor burden that you may have. So I'm really excited to talk to you and share with you today custom attributes and how it might assist you in what you're doing today. Once we get to Autodesk Build, you'll see the ability when you go to create the RFI to first be able to enter in that RFI number as it's being created. So as I, as a general contractor, can go ahead and put that sub RFI number and log it as I'm writing it. Or I can do those other items, those attributes that I'd want to search and be able to do. This can happen either as you create it or even later on in the process. But once it's there, we can then easily come to the filter tab and filter that information to find it. So if I'm that general contractor who got that phone call from that steel subcontractor looking for RFI 15, I can simply put that in and it'll search the system, and I can have that and even collaborate further and send that information. Please reach out to Autodesk to learn more about how we can assist you with custom attributes.